Dear friends, in this video, I am going to discuss about the how watchdog SEBI criticized by Karnada High Court. SEBI's role in Franklin Templeton crisis drags ill of Karnada High Court. Will the watchdog SEBI amend the mutual fund regulation to curtail the power of the trustees to wound up the mutual fund schemes? SEBI has drawn flak from the Karnada High Court for its handling of Franklin Templeton crisis that led the asset manager to shut six of its debt schemes. SEBI did not possess a copy of the resolution dated April 23 passed by the board of directors of the Franklin Templeton trustees providing for winding up, and did not respond to the email dated April 14 sent by the asset management company Templeton, the court observed in its judgment. SEBI also failed to reply the letter dated April 20 addressed by the trustee, in which permission and the guidance of the regulator was sought for winding up the schemes. The court further observed that SEBI was not aware whether compliances of the subclasses A and B of the classes 3 of the regulation 39 was made by the trustee. This class deals with the trustees giving notice disclosing the circumstances leading to the closure of the scheme to the board and in two daily newspapers and in a vernacular one. SEBI did not bother to even enquire about the compliance with the class 3 of the regulation 39 of the mutual fund regulations by the trustees. SEBI did not bother to ascertain whether redemptions and borrowing ceased, assuming that compliance of the class 3 of the regulation 39 was made, the High Court observed. The court also criticized SEBI for not placing on record a copy of an order appointing a forensic auditor and producing it before the court on September 2, even though the hearing had commenced on August 12. Very late. As a watchdog, SEBI was expected to play a very proactive role by questioning the AMC trustees and sponsor about the compliances with the provisions of the mutual fund regulations. The investors, unit holders of the said schemes will be justified in their criticism that SEBI was a silent spectator, the High Court observed. Karnada High observation may lead SEBI to review the regulation governing the succession of mutual funds, which gave power to the trustees to conclude the schemes after taking unit holders' consent without requiring an approval from SEBI. So presently, without approval from SEBI, the mutual fund can be closed by its trustee after taking permission from its unit holders by convening a meeting of the unit holders. As per Regulation 39.2A, whereby 75% of the unit holders may require a scheme to be wound up. So, when a special resolution has been passed by the unit holders to wind up the scheme, then the trustees has the power to wind up the scheme without obtaining prior approval from the SEBI. While uploading the validity of the regulations 39 to 40 on the mutual fund regulation, the court has observed that when the trustees decide to wind up a scheme by taking recourse to subclass A of the class 2 of the regulation 39, the trustee company is bound by its statutory obligation under subclass C of the class 15 of the regulation 18 to obtain the consent of the unit holders. SEBI has the option of challenging the judgment, High Court judgment, by filing a special leave petition before the Supreme Court. SEBI may not immediately change the regulation pertaining to winding up the scheme, but will appeal to Supreme Court on the observation that it did not act proactively. So SEBI may appeal to Supreme Court on the criticism made by Karnada High Court that it has not acted proactively instead of changing the regulation. Friends, video will be very interesting to you, and if you like this video, I request you to please subscribe my channel so that whenever I issue a new video on a new topic, it will reach you directly. Thanking you once again, R.V. Shekhar, practicing company secretary.